Backtracking. Backtracking is an algorithm design technique for solving problems regressively by trying to build a solution incrementally, one piece at a time, and remove those solutions that fail to satisfy the constraint of the problem at any point of time. Okay, so the backtracking technique will build the solution incrementally. And during the building process, if it found that any solution that failed to satisfy our constraint, if there is any solution like that, then it will remove that solution and it will try for the next choice. Okay. It is used to solve two kinds of problem. That is the problem which deals with searching for a set of solutions. That is, if you want to find all the available solutions of a problem, we can use backtracking. And also you can use backtracking to find the optimal solution that is satisfying some constraints. Okay, both you can find using backtracking algorithm. Okay, and the solutions in backtracking are expressed as a n tuple. Okay, x1, x2, etc. up to n. Okay, and each xi will be chosen from a finite set si. Okay, and once again, it will build a solution vector one component at a time. And it uses bounding function to test whether the vector being formed has a chance of success or not. If the vector being formed, like we will add x1, then we will add x2, and each time we will check whether adding this value will lead to a solution or not. If it is not leading to a solution, then we will discard that choice and we will try the next choice. Okay. And there are two constraints. One is explicit constraint, which will restrict the value of each xi to be chosen. That is, each xi must be chosen from si only, okay? And the next constraint is implicit constraint, which determines which of the tuple in the solution space that is satisfy certain function that you will understand when I am explaining it with an example, okay? Now, let us see a problem called a fortune problem. I have already introduced the fortune problem in the previous lecture. I recommend you to refer that problem. Okay, so here we have to place 4 queen in a 4x4 chessboard. Okay, and we are assuming that we will place the first queen in first row, second queen in second row, and third queen and fourth queen in respective rows. Okay, and we have to find out only in which column we are going to place the queen so that they will not attack each other. Okay, so say I am placing the first queen in first column. Okay, by default, the first queen will be placed in first row. Okay, so let us say I am placing the first queen in first column. Okay, so I will represent it as a graph or you can say as a tree here. Okay, the nodes are I numbered just as a step one. This is step two. Okay, like that I am numbering. Okay, and in the edge I am giving a weight, that is Q1. The first queen is placed in first column. It is read as first queen is placed in first column. Okay. And let us say I am placing the second queen in second column. Okay, so it will be represented as Q2 is equal to 2. Okay, but you can see you cannot place Q2 here because it is in the line of attack of the first queen. Okay, so here I will backtrack. I will go back to the previous step. Okay, because this will not lead to a solution. Okay, so I will place Q2 into the third column. Okay, so next solution is Q2 is equal to 3. So this is not leading to any solution. So we will backtrack from here. Okay. And I will place Q2 into the third column. Okay. Now, let us place Q3. So Q3 can be placed here. This is the first vacant column. That is Q1 is here already. So we will not place Q3 in the first column. I am placing Q3 in the second column. Okay. So it is represented like Q3 is equal to 2, okay, placing Q3 in the second column, okay. So you can see this is in the line of attack of the second queue, okay. Q3 cannot be placed here because second queue is already here, okay. So if you place Q3 in the third column, that is, so here we are backtracking from here and I am placing Q3 in the third column, okay. But this third column is also the line of attack of the second queue. Okay, so the only available choice for Q3 are the second column and the third column. But both these columns are the line of attack of the second queue. Okay, so I am backtracking from here also. So I will reach a, I will backtrack and I will reach it here. Okay, that is the second queue is creating the problem. So I will, from this node number 6, I will backtrack up to node number 2. Okay, and next, that is, this choice is not leading to a solution. Okay, so I have to change that choice. Okay, that is, I will place Q2 in the fourth column. Okay, so Q2 will be placed in the fourth column. Okay, now if I place Q3 in the second column, like this, okay, the it is not in the line of attack of any other queue. So I placed Q2 in the fourth column and I placed Q3 in the second column. Okay, now let us place Q4. So Q4 you can place only here, because this is the column for Q1, this is the column for Q3, and this is the column for Q2. Okay, so Q4 you can place only here, and that is Q4 I am placing at column 3. Okay, but the column 3 is in the line of attack of the first queue. Okay, so I have to backtrack from here also. So I will go back here, that is up to this. Okay, that is the choice, the keeping Q3 in this position is not leading to a solution. So I will place Q3 here again, but that is Q3 is equal to 3, I will set, but it is in the line of attack of this queue. Okay, sorry. So I will place a Q3 here. Okay. Okay, so if I place a Q3 there, that is Q3 is equal to 3. Again, it is in the line of attack of Q2, so it is not leading to an optimal solution. So I will backtrack here. Okay. I tried all the possibilities of Q2, that is, I placed a Q2 in the second column, third column, and fourth column, but I didn't get any solution. So I will backtrack from the second node to the first node, that is, the placing of Q1. If you change the column of Q1, you may get a solution. Okay, so since I placed Q1 in the first column, this is not leading to any solution. So I placed Q1 in the second column. Okay, so Q1 will be placed in the second column. Okay, and next Q2 I can place in first. If I place Q2 in first column, you can see it is in the line of attack of Q1, so I have to backtrack here. Q2, this choice is not possible. Okay, and if I place Q2 in the third column also, it is in the line of attack of first two column, so this choice is also not leading to a solution. So I will backtrack from here also. And if I place Q2 in the fourth column, that is Q2 is equal to 4. Okay, you can see it is not in the line of attack of any other queue. So this is one of the possible choice. Okay, so next I will place Q3 in the first column. So you can see it is not in the line of attack of any other queue. So I can place Q3 in the first column. Okay, so Q3 is equal to 1. Okay, now Q4, only available place to keep Q4 is the column 3, because all other columns are already occupied. Okay, so if I place Q4 in the third column, you can see these four queues are not in the line of attack of each other, that is, no two queues can attack each other. Okay, so this is the optimal solution, that is, this path Q1 equal to 2, this path is leading to an optimal solution, and this is not leading to the solution. Okay, so the not the optimal solution is leading to a solution. Okay, so the solution vector to the four queue problem is Q1 is equal to 2, okay, and then Q2 is equal to 4, then Q3 is equal to 1, and Q4 equal to 3. So this is the solution vector for the 4-queue problem. Okay, now let us formally define it. That is, we assumed that Q9 is to be placed in row I, okay, and all solution to the 4-queue problem is expressed in a tuple, 4-tuple, x1, x2, x3, x4. And each xi is the column in which that we are placing the Q9. Okay. And there is a bounding function. It says that if you are at, say, this node, okay, that is, says you are starting from node 1, 2, okay, and if you are currently at node 3, this will be in this choice, node 1, 2, 3 choice, the Q will not attack each other. Okay. And if you are adding a next choice, choice number 4, in that choice also the queen should not attack each other, that is defined in the bounding function formally here. Okay, and the explicit constraint is that the value of xi should be either 1, 2, 3, or 4. Okay, that is first row, first column, second column, third column, or fourth column. And the implicit constraint is that no two queen can be attacked. Okay, that is no two queens can be on the same diagonal.